The top part is the funnel with a screen. Below that, you can see where the funnel comes down and one of the heating elements that makes it a heated tipping bucket rain gauge. Inside, there's another heating element around the edge, and there is the tipping bucket. The funnel directs the precipitation into the tipping bucket, and the tipping bucket fills and then overflows as it tips. Every time the tipping bucket tips, a magnet goes by a reed switch, which creates a momentary contact closure. And that contact closure signal comes out through these two white wires and travels down this wire into a pendant data logger. So this data logger records every tip, every closure from that reed switch, and then also the time, temperature, and voltage of the data logger battery. You can connect your power source to these wires on the side, and there's an internal thermostat that keeps the heated rain gauge at the right temperature to melt snow and ice. With this data logger, we use a shuttle to collect the data. Once a month, we visit each rain gauge and insert the pendant data logger into the shuttle and press the switch to transfer the data to the shuttle. Once it's done blinking and gives us the green light, we can take the shuttle back to the lab and transfer the data from the shuttle to our computer. We have 5 of these rain gauges, 4 are deployed in the field right now, and we've put them in kind of a localized area so that we can see the rainfall pattern in a small area, how much it varies. So if in the metro area you get 1/4 inch of rain, and in our small rain gauge network you get in general 1/4 inch of rain, we might get 0.2 inches here and 0.27 here, so we kind of want to see how variable the rainfall patterns are. So that's what we're using this network of rain gauges to collect data for.